Have you started a new service-based business and you're wondering how to get your first few clients? Or perhaps you already have a service-based business, but you've been struggling to get clients consistently. Now in this video, I'm gonna share my 9 favorite ways on how to find clients for your service-based business. As a marketing mentor and business mentor, I have worked with a lot of different types of service-based online businesses. And I even run my own service-based online business, Chris Media. We do done-for-you social media marketing. And so one of the single biggest problem that I see a lot of service-based businesses face is getting consistent clients for their business. Now, before we jump into my 9 favorite ways on how to get clients for your service-based business, on this channel, we do a lot of videos on online marketing and online business. So if you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. All right, let's jump into the first strategy on how to get clients for your service-based business. So for me, the number one thing I always tell all service-based businesses is you don't want to hide what you know. You know, there are a lot of service providers out there. I am very sure you've got a lot of competitors out there. And so it's so important that you stand out from all your competitors out there. And the way you do that is by showing your ideal paying customers what you know. Now, I do know some service providers out there who are a little shy by nature, they're a little bit introverted, and they don't want to be out there in public. However, you have to realize that without showing who you are and without showing your knowledge and your expertise, it's really, really hard to build trust with your ideal paying customer. So number one strategy is don't hide your knowledge. Create content consistently. If there's anything any service provider out there should be doing, it's creating content that demonstrates their knowledge. So start by thinking, what type of content does your ideal paying customer like to consume? And then start creating content in those platforms and around those topics that you know will be useful and educational for your ideal paying customer. Now, the second strategy on how to find clients for a service-based business is what I always tell people. You gotta zero in on your target market as well as your message. So what does that mean? That means that you need to know exactly who your ideal paying client is. A lot of service-based businesses don't know exactly who they're trying to target with their marketing, with their content. So as you follow strategy number one and stop hiding and start creating content, you want to make sure that your content, your marketing is reaching the right audience. You don't want to be creating content. You don't want to be running ads to people who will never become your paying clients. So zero in on who you're trying to target, and then zero in on your messaging to make sure that it resonates with your target market. Now, the third strategy on finding clients for your service-based business is get publicity. Now, this is a strategy that I focused on a lot when I started Chris Media and when I was a brand new online entrepreneur. I went out and tried to find as many places as possible that I could appear on. So podcast interviews, live stream interviews, magazines, industry websites, so on and so forth. I was trying to get publicity all the time. And the reason why publicity is so helpful for a service-based business is because it really builds that authority. It really sets you apart from your competitors. If you put yourself in the shoes of your ideal paying customer, who will you have more trust in, right? Someone who has been featured by Forbes, has been on 100 podcast interviews, or someone who is saying that they're really, really good, but no one has ever featured them or talked about them. So think about publicity. Now, strategy number four are business organizations. Now, a lot of times business organizations are associated with in-person, offline businesses. However, there are online business organizations that would be absolutely great for you to join and be a part of. Now, I'm talking about business organizations in the formal sense, but also in the informal sense, like masterminds and memberships. Those could also be business organizations that you can be a part of. Now, the point of joining business organizations and finding clients from there is because you're building a relationship with the other members in the business organization, right? So say, for example, if there's a business organization in the state that you're in, the city that you're in, the country that you're in, wouldn't it be so great to join that business organization and then find your clients amongst the members in that business organization? So don't just think about in-person business organizations, the traditional ones, but also think about, you know, things like mastermind and memberships that could also be a stand-in for business organizations online. Now, the fifth strategy is network and partnership. So here I'm talking about things like agency white label. One of the things that I did when I started Chris Media was to approach other marketers, approach other agencies out there, and try to see if they are not already offering a social media marketing service or messenger bot marketing service, if we could partner up with them and work with their clients. In exchange, we'll give them a commission or whatever that we earn. So for me, network and partnership is such an important strategy for service-based businesses. If you have a service-based business, go out there and try to find complementary businesses that are not offering what you offer, but they have customers that would benefit from whatever that you are selling. Now, number six is running paid ads. Now, my advice is if you are a brand new service-based business, I do not recommend that you start out by running paid ads. Now, my reason for that is because paid ads are not the best way to reach cold audiences. So if you are a brand new business, the chances are you probably don't have an existing audience yet. So you would need to run paid ads to reach cold audiences. Now, what we know about paid ads is that it's really, really difficult to get great return on investments if you are targeting cold audiences. So I would focus on strategies like number one, creating content, you know, getting publicity, right? Building my audience, building my email list before I focus on running paid ads. However, if you already have an existing service-based business and you're just trying to find a fuel to ignite, like reignite and amplify all the things that you've been doing, then paid ads are great, you know, especially retargeting ads, right? So retargeting people who visit your website or consume your content. Now, strategy number seven are referrals. So there are two types of referrals. There's the professional referrals where you approach your past colleagues, your bosses, your clients, and you ask them to refer you to people who might be your ideal paying customers or who would benefit from your services. And then the second type of referral is the personal referral. So people in your family, your friends, your personal network. Now, personally, when it comes to getting my first few clients for any service-based business, I would go to referrals first. I would actually reach out to my professional network and my personal network and ask for referrals. With referrals alone, it is easy to get your first few clients, all right? So if you are brand new and you are wondering how to get your first few clients for your service-based business, why not try the referrals route first? Now, strategy number eight, SEO, search engine optimization. When it comes to marketing your service-based business organically, so without paid ads, one of the best ways to get qualified leads is to have your ideal paying customers find you through SEO, so through Google, for example, right? So while they're searching for a solution on Google, they find your website, they click on it, and then now they are absolutely qualified and really hot and warm leads. The reason why they are great is because when someone finds you on Google, chances are they're already searching for a solution, versus if they were to consume your content on, say, Instagram, they might still be cold audience and not yet ready to find a solution to whatever problem that they're facing. So what you want to do with this strategy is to make sure that your website is SEO optimized. Now, what does that mean? It means getting your website ready to be found and ranked by Google in the first page, ideally, right? So that could mean working with an SEO optimization specialist to help you optimize your website. That could mean creating content on your website and having it on your website. So even if you're creating, you know, YouTube videos, you want to have those YouTube videos on your website as well. And then the last strategy for me is finding speaking up opportunities. One of the things that I personally strived for when I started Chris Media was to get on as many stages in person or online as possible. For me, getting in front of stages and speaking about what I know and sharing my knowledge and teaching people what I know has been one of the best ways to quickly build my authority in the topic matter. Now, speaking on stages virtually or in person might not translate to getting a client directly from that conference or the event or the workshop. However, you're building momentum, you're building authority, you're building content, and you're building visibility. So definitely think about speaking opportunities that you can speak at. Now, of course, this year is a little different, so you might want to find online speaking opportunities such as virtual summits or even live stream shows. Go out there and pitch yourself as a speaker. So I hope you found those nine strategies on how to find clients for your service-based business useful. These are the nine strategies that I've been really focused on as I was growing Chris Media, my own service-based business. And these are the nine strategies that work really well for the clients that I work with. Now, let me know in the comments below what has worked really well for your service-based business. And if you like today's video, don't forget to hit the like button as well as to hit the subscribe button if you have not already subscribed to the channel. Now, in the meantime, as you wait for my next video, don't forget to go check out this video to learn more about online marketing and online business. I appreciate your time and I'll see you in the next video.